afternoon, everyone. It's a real pleasure to welcome. We are reviewing TransCanada's permit application for Keystone XL pipeline to cross the U.S.-Canadian border. As you know, this includes analysis and assessment of multiple factors, as well as reviewing hundreds of thousands of comments that have been received during the public comment period. We are leaving no stone unturned in this process, and we expect to make a decision on the permit before the end of this year. With respect to Keystone, we are planning to issue the final environmental impact statement this month. Then once that final statement is issued, interested federal agencies on our side, including the Department of Energy and the Environmental Protection Agency, under our laws have a 90-day period to review and provide their views on whether a permit should be issued. We think it's critically important to hear the public's views, and so the State Department in September will host public meetings in all six of the states through which the pipeline will pass. We've been clear from the beginning that the safety of the pipeline is one of our highest priorities. We have not only conferred with the EPA, but also with an organization called the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Association. And we have worked diligently to ensure we have full understanding of all of the consequences, including the very important point that the minister made to me about energy security and what that means for our two countries. And we have worked with the applicant, with TransCanada, to develop a set of conditions above and beyond what is required by law to ensure that if the permit is issued, the project will be as safe as it could possibly be. But because I am very conscious of the role that I play and that the State Department plays, that is as full an explanation as I can provide. Thank you all very much. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So now, where are you off to now?